Hello and welcome back to the fourth edition of Candid Talks with Moms. Eid Mubarak to all those who are celebrating. This is a month of a lot of celebrations. So hopefully, slowly, steadily, our lives will bounce back to normal. And while we do that, in the meanwhile, let's cherish all the moments that we spent with our family. I welcome you all and hope I'm audible. Let me bring in our speaker for today. Her name is Tejal Choksi. She is a mother of a sweet girl and she has been doing multiple things. So, in order for you all to know how she went ahead with her life and her motherhood, let's bring her in. All right, just give me a moment. If you are watching, please share your comments, your feedback, because that really helps us and becomes interactive. So welcome, Tejal. Thank you so much for accepting the request to be on Candid Talks with Mom. And it's so wonderful to have you here. You've mentioned about a lot of things that you've been doing in spite of being a mother. So I would not take more time. I will let you talk about your journey and let us know how it has been since you've become a mother.
So, hi, Farida. Thank you so much for inviting me and thank you for having this interaction. I really appreciate it. Eid Mubarak to you and to all our fellow mothers who have, you know, pushed themselves towards having a career as well. So, coming to the first, the thing about motherhood is that it puts you in a very abundant energy. Sure, there are a lot of challenges, but those challenges make you use up and recycle everything that you have and create something new. So for me, that was what it was post motherhood. It's like I had to give myself time to recover physically, mentally. And then I started my journey again from, let's just say, from scratch, not even a zero. Zero is still a number. So I started my journey. You know, I went back to schooling. Like I went back to apply for job as a fresher. I applied at 35 different places and I got through just one. It was tough.
Wow.
And then from there, I worked as a teacher for 2 years, two consecutive years. That is just when my daughter was a year and 10 months. So there were some financial constraints and I had to also share the load, as we say. So I was sharing the load and it kind of, I had to take my daughter also to the school. That's just how I was taking her to school along with me before her, even her playgroup started. That was way back in 2010. 2010 ending and 2011 and 12. Thereafter that, I decided to make it more concrete, my teaching career. So I said, okay, let me see how far I can go. So since I had done my graduation, I thought, okay, let me also see if I can do an additional degree, because everyone kept telling me, why don't you, means everyone in sense, the principals, the person, the people who interviewed me in the school, they all said, why don't you do something on, you know, additional, so that you have a focus that where you, yeah. So it was like that. And then I did my MBA while I was teaching and so on and so on. And my daughter's 12 years, but I had a sporadic career, I would say. Like I had to stop and start, stop and start. And I did my master's while I was, teaching in school for 2 years. And the last year was a bit tough. So I took a break for 6 months. Monetary wise, it was just a circle. You pay here, your bills are being paid here, and here you get the salary. It was tough, but it was a learning. It's a big learning. Uh,
Tejal, we've
I'm sorry.
lost you. Okay, yeah.
I'm
Yeah.
sorry. Yeah. So,
Your voice is cracking. Can't hear you. Okay.
okay. One second. I'm just okay. You can hear me all right?
Yes.
Okay. So, well, then I had this. We relocated also. So for my daughter, we hunted for some schools. Then you know how it is. We have to put the school in the financial budget, and we have to fit the.
Okay, your voice is breaking again. So
Okay.
can you repeat that? Yes.
Yeah, so basically it's like we had to like find the school which would fit into our finances and our finances to fit into our lifestyle and then our lifestyle to fit back into the schooling again. And
Wow.
so we were a kind of it was a financial challenge. It was it is scary in the beginning, but you just breathe in, breathe out, and sleep well. Take care of yourself. Take care of your daughter. I mean, my daughter. That is, I took care. I kind of. I had to. You end up letting go of a lot of things because, as it is, motherhood is sacrifice. Apart from that, you end up letting go of all the things which are not required. So basically, you learn leaning out very fast. You become an expert at managing your house. You become an expert at managing only what is extremely necessary and what will help you survive and thrive. So your entire thought process will revolve around that once we become mothers, and that is the key to pushing ourselves to keep working, you know, after becoming a mother also. Yeah.
Right. So you had mentioned that you had, you had worked at different places. So what made you stick around, apart from like, okay, it was financial, but how did you manage all this? How did you manage to stick around with your job?
But I managed to stick around with my job because I wanted to learn. I was not, see, finances is a big part of parenthood, I would say. Father or mother,
yes.
Single parent or codependency. I'm sorry, I shouldn't be using that word, but well, mother, father or mother, single parents or
yes.
Parenthood, whatever. Learning is very important. So for me, it was like, so what if I'm a mother? You know, my thought was, so what if I have already done? I mean, I saw so many people who are younger than me, who were, you know, growing faster, who were learning faster. And there were times when I had to sit back and learn from them. So I had to keep a section of my mind completely blank and accept. So acceptance is the reason what made me stick to my job. More or less. I mean, even if it was something like if I reach late, I have to listen, or if I'm not, feedback of the customers when I worked in BPO, or when I did dermatoglyphics multiple intelligence tests, that was the counseling part for students and parents, or I was a course coordinator. So these are the things wherein there was a lot of learning and a lot of push and pull. Between students, professors, between students' management, between professors and their time management. So everywhere I was going with one thing, whatever it is, I will accept it and do whatever I can at my best. Today I will do this much and hold on. And that's how I kept going in my workplace. That is the one factor which kept me motivated. So, yeah. That was the thing because
yeah, okay.
Because as parents,
completely agree.
Yeah, because as parents, sometimes we don't want to make mistakes. We don't want to harm our kids, or we don't want to we don't want them to learn incorrect things. But circumstances, environment, and our behaviors somewhere show the shadow side of it in them. So, you know, there were times, like I'm just saying, like I did not want my daughter to fall off in her sleep and hit her head, which has happened a couple of times because I was deep in sleep. And even though I kept her protected, yet, you know, still she would tumble down. She was just tiny, just maybe a year and a half. So I used to feel bad for that, feel bad for leaving her and going to work. So the same way, you know, that's the factor that, no, this should not happen again. That would make me more vigilant. The same way at workplace, if at all there is something which is, you know, not correct, or something which is pointed out to me that I'm not supposed to do, then I would just be more vigilant and make sure that, okay, this is something that I'm not supposed to do. I'm sorry about that. My daughter just came in. Sorry about that. I'm sorry.
Tell her to say hi to everyone. It's okay.
Say hi.
Hi, Siddharth. How are you?
Fine.
She's got lovely hair.
Yeah, she's a little fond.
We should actually do a session of mother and kids.
Yeah.
Really, I mean, this gives me an idea that, you know, why don't we have a mother and kids session instead of just having mothers? Because I'm sure the kids are really proud of their parents.
Yeah, we should, because they will, you know, let out all our secrets.
Great. So, as you said that you went, you mentally prepared yourself to accept everything. Do you think somewhere your career progression also was affected because of motherhood? You could have reached higher, maybe, you know, got more promotions and done much better had it not been for motherhood?
I would never choose that option, like ever. Because...
But did it affect, did it in any ways affect... your career progression?
My career progression, it... see, I don't know what's... I would give you a... Let's just be very honest. On the Likert scale, if I were unmarried and if I were getting a promotion or something like that, then I wouldn't have cared less. I'm being honest. I would have gone, you know, I would have taken it up. If I have to travel, if I'm getting more perks, if I have to getting a better position, I would have. Once married, then on the Likert scale, it's kind of an imbalance, because my energy, for me as a person, my energy will go into my family first. So I do not have, I'm already drenched and I'm already parched off. The work is just a second priority, and it is only for, it is for recognition, it is for, you know, finances also. But at the end of it, it's the second priority. So motherhood, once motherhood happened, my child is my only priority first. And then family, and then, you know, work. So it kind of rotates for a mother in a mother's life. But I wouldn't have chosen otherwise. And motherhood has not made any difference in my career, per se. But the perspective of motherhood and mothers being in the house, like mothers are not supposed to work and they are supposed to be in the house and, you know, take care of their child. And that perspective still exists. It does.
Okay. Yes.
I have experienced it. So I can tell, yes, it does exist. I'm sorry, but I also faced it many times, and I had to, you know, tell them, okay, my finances are, my finances need improvement. So I'm looking for work. So there are things like, you know, I have to compromise my family sometimes for my work. And I tell my family, now they are used to it. But at the workplace, it is always a new thing that, you know, tomorrow, if anything happens to her child, what if she's pregnant again? You know, they have their own set of questions. So, you know, so many...
They are more insecure than us.
Yes, actually. But
Yes, that is very true.
and then they decide, oh, how old are you? So you are what, 30? So do you plan to have another baby in another year or two? And then supposing if we are not well for a day or two, so what they feel the heat of the house as if, you know, they are holding the pressure of my in-laws or my family. It's not just me, across all mothers, it is heavy. It feels a little burdensome to hire a mother for a long time. I guess the guilt factor and the care factor, it kind of seeps through. So at workplace, motherhood is not making any change to anyone's career, I feel, at least my perspective. Sure, it may be different for everyone, but definitely it's making a difference to the person who's hiring us. They want people for a longer time and they want people to give more time to their workplace. But we are on the other side of the Likert scale, so it kind of does not serve the score, I would say. I'm sorry, I'm being a little honest here, but since I've been
No,
through that struggle.
I'm happy that you're being honest, but that's what candid talks is all about. Just be yourself, talk about it, because sometimes you know what, we just have so much inside us, nobody to really talk to other than just the family.
Yes.
And if people we are talking with have never worked, they will never understand what we are going through. Okay, so if it is
True.
your in-laws or somebody who have never worked, like the mothers, then they find it very difficult to understand what we are going through. So when we talk to people who have that common wavelength, then it becomes easier for us to talk. So you know, it is always within us, and this platform is mainly for that. Let's talk. Let's just talk. I mean, I'm not sure anybody can. I mean, I can make any difference in anybody's life, but at least when we get a forum to talk, we feel happy. At least we feel lighter, and we feel that there are many who are like us. It's not just all alone. You know, just me all alone in this kind of a situation.
Especially for mothers, I'm telling you, I was parched completely. Once I was a mother, I was completely parched. I needed to connect to mothers in community, across any race, across any religion, as long as they are mothers and we come together and share each other's children experiences and share each other's day-to-day lives and how are they managing to find work. We as mothers, it's very important for us to communicate what we have been through, and what seems difficult is actually normal. It is normal, but it is scary also, but it is difficult also, all the three. So we have to deal with it on a day-to-day basis. There are no shortcuts. I had to come out of that whole fear zone and being scared all the time. I would sweat. I developed skin rashes because of my fear. So
My God.
this is at workplace. It's not that nobody knew about it. I went through that treatment for like 3 months or so, and like my entire hands and all of it. But that was a side effect of the pressure that I was taking. So things
Wow.
like these
Oh.
happen. You know, things
Yes.
like these happen. It took time to recover, but that's just, if not this, something else or something else. So yes, mothers need to connect with mothers, and it's important that our mothers and the you know, from the paternal and the maternal families, they should connect, keep us connected to mothers from other races as well as from our, so that
Yeah.
we have a rapport, we share a rapport, not just kitty parties. We're not talking kitty over here. We just need to, yeah, you know, like they say, vomiting is normal. Like they say, teeth bleeding is normal. Like I used to go through these websites and read those articles and all. I'm just going a little back on my motherhood days, because in a way I do miss being a mother, like to a little toddler now that she's grown. So I'm just saying. So that time, those were the things which were normal. So when we are at work, what are the things which are considered normal? You know? we never received that coaching or anything. We just went our own way and just managed with whatever we had. So motherhood is not having a major impact on our careers, because career we as mothers are very accepting of whatever works and whatever we can contribute to the work. However, at workplace, it is making a difference to hire mothers. They value mothers. At the same time, it makes the whole quotient of having a mother on board a little heavier than having a person who is not married, who's single, or who's not a mother, because they do not have physical human responsibility. They do have parents. Just a shout out to everyone that I understand. Don't shoot me for this, but they have parents. But having your own child, a growing human being around us, is a responsibility very different in its own way. So that is the thing, yeah.
So Tejal, tell me something. If you were given an opportunity, so maybe it has nothing to do with your finances, nothing. If you were given an opportunity to be a stay-at-home mom, would you have liked that?
Yes. At one point, I would say yes. Today, okay. Since my mother is grown, I'm sorry. Since my daughter is grown, she's 12, and she herself tells me, Mommy, you can go to work for a few hours. Like, I'll manage. Because now she's grown, she wants to have her own independence. So I can understand that. But at one point in time, yes, I was craving to be at home and I couldn't be at home. I wanted to, but I couldn't. And I had to go to work. It is tough. It is really tough. At least for the first 6 months, it is very tough. So yes, I would have loved to stay at home until she was 5. Till then, sorry.
Right. So what, I mean, was there some kind of a support system, something that you depended on when you did mention that you took her to work with you, but is there anything else that you needed as a support to when you went to work? Because obviously you said that you were working. So who was taking care? Was it a daycare? Was it somebody at home who was looking after your child where you could, be at peace when you were working and concentrate on your work also?
Yeah, I was actually not dependent on anyone. I was totally by my daughter till she was 4 years old, completely.
Okay.
My in-laws stayed for 2 months in between for a vacation. They came for a vacay and they left. And yes, I besides all of this, we require financial help, financial support. Family should give that. And mother, of course, our own mothers, or the mother of husband's mother, that is. So maternal or paternal mother, but mother must be there for the child. For as a biggest support system for a mother is a mother first. That is what I have experienced, and I can, vouch for that completely. Because
so it was your mom. You took support from your own mom.
Yes, my own mom. Because what happened is, when my daughter was 4 years and 4.5 years, my mom-in-law passed away. She had some chronic health issues. So
sorry,
she passed away. That's And after that, we had to look out for location for her school as well as for my work. That was a task. And that is where my mother came into picture, because I needed my mom to take care of her while I was in the school working. So luckily, I got to work in her own school for 2 years while I was doing my master's. And thereafter, I worked in corporate for 6 months. Then I worked as a DMIT counselor. Then I worked as a course coordinator. Then I worked as a senior customer care executive in Teleperformance while I did my interns and I did my ECC in early childhood. I wanted to go for a full-fledged teaching career. So I said, okay, because it was like a, testing method that, okay, I have always been able to manage my house very well with school, few work hours. So I decided to go for that. And among all of this, through all these years, my mom has always been there. If not my mom, sometimes my brother, sometimes my sister. So even my relatives, when she's not well. So it's like, it's a give and take relation with our own family for each other. Like when she's not well or something. Once in a while, neighbors. So these are all small help that we readily have to accept. If any mother wants to work, the first thing is, I'm ready to accept whatever help you give me. I'm thankful for helping. I'm very thankful for the help. And I'm ready to help you whenever, with whatever I can. I think this is the thing that I kept on, that kept me going for a very long time. There were times when my managers would be really, you know, I was doing overtime actually. So I'm just saying one of those things at my workplace. So we had this, when we do overtime, we get paid more. So I used to tell, so I told my mom, don't wait for me at night. I'll come straight up in the morning, 5 o'clock. Then mommy will say, okay, you don't come home. You stay there only. You work and you come back home. And I would sleep there on that same chair for an hour. Get up and and then go on the next chair and then work. Just because we were getting some incentives. I mean, that was the time to earn. It was just 2-3 months where we get some opportunities like that. So everyone used to do that. All of us. Mothers, fathers. Fathers used to work 16 hours straight up. We used to be shocked that fathers are working so hard. So when it comes to motherhood, it's very important to have a mother around. Very, very important. I would say, if your mom is with you, you just have God with you. That's it. That's it. Because she'll take care of things. She knows you. She is a part of your DNA, your husband's mother or your own mother. And, you know, the whole system is taken care of. The thing is, I did try to put her in daycare when I was working. And they had crèche. But we had night shifts till 2 o'clock and the crèches were only open till 10 at night. So who will take care? And we were family back then. And then gradually it the responsibility came all over me and I ended up being a single mom. So now I'm trying to find job again and see wherever I can, make a difference, where the organization thinks I can make a difference. I might find a job again. I'm just being honest. But mom has to be around.
So currently you're not working.
Ever since I was working till February this year, I was working as an event anchorer for Tiny Teen Preschool. Eventually, because of COVID, the plans for this year working over there has been dropped. And I have applied in a lot of places, but it's the same. I'm sorry, but the struggle for mothers to have a separate HR, a separate website where only mothers can apply, seriously. And only those HRs who will take mothers, because once we work and if we take a break in between for our children, if we have some connectivity in corporate specifically, it would make a difference. It is like name, place, animal thing, that game. I'm just saying, in that game, like we have to write the name, place, animal thing. But what if I have to write name can be just any name. But what if I choose in terms of animal or bird? What if I write a name of a dish fruits and vegetables? Those are the things which don't come in name, place, animal thing. Sure, it is a game, but I'm just saying, can it not be tweaked a little bit? Like at workplace, we should have a separate HR completely working only for mothers. Specific. It would make your group, motherhood to careerhood, like we have these groups where we are coming together during this time. It is hard for me to find a job. It is hard for me to, run my own regular errands. Like I'm doing whatever I can. So the same way, they should have these HR groups where they can pick up women and they can give them jobs for the, specifically for mothers, because mothers are, they are in that codependency energy, or they are in that energy of a very in and out energy with their children, where things are not planned to a large extent. So if someone leaves, they have mothers, but they have it for servants. They have agencies for that. They have agencies for managers. So they can have agencies for mothers only. Just saying.
So yes, there are quite a few websites that do you know, specifically do this, but I'm not sure how many really get through them. So there are quite a few. I will post it again in the group, which are all those websites and which are all those groups that really help. Yes, that is really the need of the hour. I mean, I've seen many big corporate houses which have these return programs and things like that for mothers. But how effective they are, I've really not heard from anybody who is really, you know, bought in through them. So the world is changing, but like I said, it will take maybe another a few more years. Maybe like I just read today about New Zealand's Prime Minister passing a bill of equal pay for men and women. So it is going to take time, but it is happening. Okay, and I feel it is our generation who really worked for it, and maybe little it started maybe with the previous generation where women had started working, and our generation has taken it a little ahead. Maybe the next generation will reap the fruits of this, hopefully.
Yeah, sure. Yes, yeah. True. The way my mom has struggled, and the way the ladies before me have struggled, the teachers, those principals, my seniors when I was a kid, yes, they worked so hard. They worked very hard during their times. Now they are the lifers of society. Yes, true. And in a way, we are reaping the fruits, you know, of our success. The credit goes to them for everything that they have done. Because if it were not for my mom, master's in, you know, the postgraduate degree that I did, it was not possible. She was there. She was always there. And I was running in the morning, 7 o'clock in the school to 12:30, then 1:30 come back home, and then again go away for my lectures from 3 o'clock until 7, 8, or probably 9, depending on the professors, because it was part time and even they were running hotspots, and we were all professionals, working professionals. So we would end up being late on the lectures. We would end up being absent. This is just one part of the whole circle that I'm saying. Like, we need a lot of people along the way as mothers to manage. It is multitasking personally, internally, and also externally. It's just that I don't know why it appears very heavy, but it is not. Being a mother, when we have mothers around, you know, the work actually becomes a lot easier. It does. So yes, whatever we are today is because of the ladies who worked hard for us back then. And, you know, we are paving the way for the ladies ahead of us, you know, born ahead of us.
Yes.
It's true. I really hope so. It should change. I mean, I love equality. I'm not a feminist I'm not a man hater or men hater. But I most definitely love equality between men and women. It should be equal, especially when it comes to the same task work. It should be equal pay. There has to be equal working hours, etc. Yeah.
So hopefully things will change, Tejal. And it was really nice speaking to you. Thank you so much for sharing so many personal things and enlightening most of us in our groups. I hope whoever is listening to us right now as well as later on will be able to connect with the conversations we had. So before I let you go, I just wanted to know, is there a parting tip or suggestion or anything that you would want to give to the group, the ladies in the group, any way which somebody would want to reach out to you? What would you like to say to them?
Yes, for all the ladies out there, I would like to give you five tips for managing your career after motherhood. That is, sure, you already know this, but I'm just saying which has worked for me. In this world where you can be anything, have mercy and be kind. Number one. Number two, time will manage things. Do not lose your temper over small things. Number three, smile often. Number four, listen to your child. You may not have all the answers, but just listen to your child. And
It's so
number
important.
five, yes, number five, your career will happen again and again. Motherhood is a part of your life. So these are the five things that I want to share with all the viewers. And regarding any help, yes, I do have, when it comes to professional connections, I have my profile on LinkedIn. I have it on Naukri, Shine. I also am on Facebook as well. I have connectivity with managers with whom I have worked previously. And I have also worked as an HR recruiter for a very short span of time, for about 100 days. So I have connectivity with a few people whom I can forward their CVs. I can give them their numbers if they are looking for work. I mean, it's the struggle remains, but then where there is struggle is there, is where success comes. It's not easy,
Yes.
but the effort matters. So just these are the things that I would like to share. And yes, definitely, I have connectivity with a lot of people, principals. I have been given presentations in so many schools, almost all schools in Dahisar. So I have a lot of places covered. So I can help them. At least I can give them the right networking, whatever I can from my end, when it comes to school field or education field, that is.
Great, that is so wonderful and so nice of you and kind of you. So Tejal, it was really wonderful talking to you. Thank you very much for sharing your views and being on the fourth Candid Talks with Moms. We will keep in touch, and all those who are listening to us, thank you very much for your time. Have a
Thank
wonderful
you for
evening and a wonderful Sunday.
sure. Thank you. Take care.
Bye.
Bye.